Hello and welcome to this short video about how to test a battery management system with the software-in-the-loop technology. My name is Martin Rühl. I'm product manager at dSpace.
My name is Sophia Vollmering. I'm an application engineer at dSpace and I work on SIL simulation topics in the context of e-mobility, especially on battery management systems.
So let's start with a short introduction. What is the battery management system? Let's assume you have an electric car. What is the most important part of this car? It's the battery. The battery is the cost-intensive part of this car. The battery describes how far you can drive with this car, and so on and so on. And one important topic of a battery is the so-called state of charge. The battery should be within 20% and 90%, something like this. And the battery consists of several cells, and they have to be balanced and all this stuff. We have high voltages, and you want that your battery has a long lifetime, more than 10 years, something like this. So all that has to be managed, and that's called a battery management system. And our task now is to test the software of this battery management system. So how to test this? What options do we have? Of course, we can test in the real world, drive around and measure all the things we want to test, one option. Very expensive, very time-consuming. The next option would be to use a so-called hardware-in-the-loop test system. In that case, we are simulating the vehicle, but we are using the real-world control unit. So the ECU, the electronic control unit, is connected in the control loop. That's why it's called hardware-in-the-loop. But we want to test the software only. So why to use a hardware? We could use the software and could introduce the software into the loop. And that's called software in the loop. And this has many, many advantages. You see here, it is easier to set up. It is not so cost intensive like HL, for example. And very interesting thing, you can slow down the simulation. You can make it faster. Depending on what you want to do and depending on what you have to test. We will see that later. So we will use software-in-the-loop testing for testing our battery management system. I could talk many, many details about that. Because of the time, I will not do so. But in case you want to have more detailed information about what is a battery simulation, how to test with HL systems, for example, or what is software-in-the-loop testing, we have here collected some links for you for more detailed information. But I think now we can start, and for that, I think Sophia has prepared some very interesting slides and can directly start the simulation. So Sophia, please start.
First, I'd like to introduce you to the general architecture of the simulation of a battery management system. A battery management system consists of a battery management controller, BMC, which is responsible for state of charge estimation and pre-charge control, and cell supervision circuits, CSCs, which monitor and balance the battery. The communication between the battery management controller and the cell supervision circuits is usually a bus communication, for example SPI or CAN. To create a virtual simulation system with which the various components of the battery management system simulation can be tested as easily and quickly as possible, we have created separate VPUs, virtual processing units, for BMC, CSCs, and battery. This allows you to replace any VPU with your system under test and easily integrated into the existing environment. We used the ASM, Automotive Simulation Model Battery Library, to create virtual processing units. This is an open Simulink model which can be used for real-time simulation and also contains projects for parametrization and instrumentation. With our PC-based simulation platform VEOS, it is possible to simulate a virtual battery management system and all necessary environment models. For measurement and calibration, we use ControlDesk. But let's dive into the tool. Here you can see ControlDesk with the different VPUs of the simulation system. On this layout, we can see the battery and the battery management system. I will now start the simulation, connect the cable, and the charging process begins. I would now like to show you how you can test the behavior of the CSCs by starting a balancing process. On this layout, you can see the cell voltage of the different cells of the battery as state of charge. The cell voltage difference is indicated here. Please note the state of charge imbalance, which is at the moment 1. I will now activate balancing. Indicated with the green light here, we see the cells that are balanced. These are the cells with the highest voltage value. Please note that the overall state of charge imbalance is decreasing at the moment. I now stop the simulation. We can see that the simulation is running more than 20 times faster locally on my PC.
Okay, Sophia, very impressive. Just to have a reminder, we have simulated 20 times faster in real time. That's possible with software loop testing. So far we had only seen, let's say, how to simulate the world around. Now we want to come to the topic, what to test. So what is the device under test? We want to test the software within our electronic control unit, an ECU. In the real world, we have something like this, a real ECU, hardware system with software running on this hardware. But we want to test the software without having the real hardware. So we have to derive, let's say, a virtual or a digital twin of it. This is called a virtual ECU. And to be able to test the software, we have to put in the software we want to test in our virtual ECU. Depending on what to test, different parts of a virtual ECU, of the software layers, have to be put in. Others have to be replaced. In this example, we replace the hardware driver because we don't have any hardware, but we want to connect our normal software to an, let's say, virtual driver layer. And with that, we have now developed a virtual ECU, which can now be simulated. For simulating, we need a simulator. Our software-in-the-loop simulator is called VEOS. And in addition to the virtual ECUs, we have to introduce a vehicle simulation, a battery or charging simulation, and we have to connect all the different parts together. And then we have a software-in-the-loop system simulation that can be simulated on a PC, as we have seen, faster than real time. We will later see slower than real time. Everything is possible. We can do tests in parallel. All that things are possible with software-in-the-loop testing. To come back to these virtual ECUs, I told you already that depending on what you want to test, you have to put different parts of the overall software within your virtual ECU. And for that, different levels, so-called levels, have been derived by a company that is called ProStep. ProStep has written a white paper. I've put here the link to it. And yeah, depending on what is part of this virtual ECU, there are levels starting from 0 up to level 4. And I think, Sophia, you have presented an additional demo, I think, with level 2. Level 2 means that we have the application software, the control software included, but we are generating, special for our tests here, special basic software parts, and I think this is something you can demonstrate to us, right?
Indeed, to give you the opportunity to test the bus communication between the BMC and the CSCs, we have created a level 2 VECU with System Desk. In this case, we implemented an isolated SPI, ISO-SPI communication, via the SPI channel. However, the specific protocol depends on the chip used. To set up the communication, we used the SPI module from System Desk. We created C code with target link, inserted it into the VCU, and implemented a specific ISO SPI communication. We have created a virtual ECU which we can test the bus communication between the BMC and the CSCs. You can set up your VCU in the same way to test your system under test with SPI communication. Let's look at the communication and control desk. I will again start the simulation and the charging process. On this temporary SPI monitor, you can observe the messages of the SPI communication that are exchanged between the battery management controller and, in our case, 6 CSCs. Due to the high number of messages, I will now reduce the simulation speed to 500 times slower than real time. At every simulation step, you can now observe chunks of 8 commands sent by the BMC requesting data from the CSCs and the corresponding responses. Now I will charge the battery by applying a constant load and produce an overvoltage. For this, I will again increase the simulation speed. I apply here a constant load. The DC link voltage now increases, and as soon as it reaches the configured maximal value, a voltage fault will be indicated by a red light, the lower main relay and the upper main relay will open. We can also observe the acute voltage fault in the SPI monitor. Therefore, we switch back to the previous layout. Down here, I've highlighted the command sent by the BMC in blue and the response from the CSC in red. The value 0 means no voltage fault, which then changes to FF, which means a voltage fault.
Okay, Sophia, thank you very much. Very impressive demonstration. So let's summarize what we have seen. We have seen that it is possible to test the software of a battery management system with the technology of software-in-the-loop. Depending on what you want to test, you can simulate faster or slower, or even go step by step through the simulation. Everything is possible because everything is software. We have also seen that DSpace is able to offer everything you need for that. We are able to offer the models, we are able to offer the tools for generating and for simulating, for test and automation. And we have the expertise, like Sophia here, in our company. So don't hesitate to ask us in case you have any questions. And in case you want to have help on setting up such a simulation, again, don't hesitate to contact us and let us be your partner in simulation and validation. Thank you very much for your attention.
DSpace, your partner in simulation and validation.